this is the official campus permit we obtained, which allowed us to promote lacrosse on the campus lawn in search of the very first Aztec lacrosse. We only found a few players who knew how to play. We had no coach, no equipment, no money, no field, but we had the energy to make it happen, and we formed a team. This is the first program created by Carrie Mangold. Our three co-founders were myself, Carrie, and Larry Caterino. Looking back, there were three factors to our success. The first was Norm Webb. Some who played high school lacrosse in San Diego may have heard the name Norm Webb. Maybe they played in the Norm Webb Memorial Tournament. But he was such an important part of lacrosse in San Diego. I think it's important for all players and alumni to understand the role that he played. In the early 60s, he won the award as the nation's number one goalie 2 years in a row at West Point. In Vietnam, he became one of the most decorated officers of his class, awarded 4 bronze stars and 2 silver stars for valor. He didn't coach the original Aztec team. He coached a men's club team in town. But he wrote me and sent me this card with a list of drills he wanted to cover at one of our first practices, and he was outstanding, teaching the fundamentals because many of the guys had never played before. Years later, though, he did serve as an assistant coach for the Aztecs. In 1983, he was elected to the U.S. Lacrosse National Hall of Fame. When he passed, Norm left his entire estate, millions I'm told, to U.S. Lacrosse. And then U.S. Lacrosse created the Webb Legacy Society so that others might do the same. The second factor in our success was the support we received from U.S. lacrosse. Way back in the 70s, the lacrosse gods in Baltimore decided that they were going to start a stick loan program to help new areas, and we were one of the first to ever receive these sticks. This was the first of hundreds of examples that I've seen over the years where U.S. lacrosse made a tremendous difference in the growth of lacrosse here on the West Coast. The third factor was the energy that our team possessed to try to promote the game. We used these same lacrosse sticks to start San Diego's first youth lacrosse league. Every original Aztec was required to either be a coach, a ref, or a league administrator. The goalie on San Diego's first youth lacrosse team, who once scored a goal going coast to coast, is currently the chair of the San Diego State International Business Department, Professor John Putman. We use the loaner sticks to introduce lacrosse at the wheelchair games. We use the sticks to teach lacrosse to children on the Rincon Indian Reservation. Helmets were $20 each, gloves only $14 each, and we raised money in three ways. One, we charged each player, ready, $40 to be on the lacrosse team. In the fall, we ran a 26-hour marathon against the rugby team, asking our fellow students to pay us per mile. I still have the form that everybody signed, and I checked their names off when they paid up. In the spring, we sold raffle tickets, 25 cents a ticket. And you know who pulled the raffle tickets at our very first game? The most famous entertainer in town, the San Diego Chicken. We somehow convinced the Daily Aztec to cover our team, and we received great coverage in that first year. On the field, we were a pretty good team. My high school teammate, Jim Bernhardt, drove from Long Island to San Diego to join in the fun. Jim was a great player. He took the opening faceoff in our very first game and 10 seconds later scored our first goal. Jim Bernhardt is currently on the staff of the Houston Texans in the NFL. He is the father of the Bernhardt boys from the University of Maryland. One just was the MVP of Team USA U19, and his two older brothers are on the Team USA team, all played for the University of Maryland. We won our first game 10-0. We also beat USC, UCLA, and in the Claremont game, we won even though we only had 10 players. I had no phone. I used the phone at the end of the dorm. It's amazing when I look back that we communicated with the opposing teams by US mail. got a letter from UC Santa Barbara giving us directions. He tells us, hey, if the gym is closed, come to my room and you can all change in my dorm room. Of course, in the letter, there's always a reference to the post-game beers. That was standard. It was expected after every game, and often the keg was rolled right onto the field. Looking back on the 40 years of blood, sweat, and beers, there were some tremendous moments that occurred shortly after the team was formed. Carlo Maglione in 1983 was voted All-American, listed right next to Bruce Seitz on the form. We had many outstanding tournaments where some of the nation's top teams came to Aztec Bowl to play. Air Force, Ohio State, Notre Dame, Denver, Rutgers. Tommy Hanum later played professionally with the Philadelphia Wings. A number of games were televised on the local cable TV station. It was magnificent. Many Aztecs, including Tommy Hanum and Russ Olson, participated for Team California in the World Championships, held in 1984 in conjunction with the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles. We placed a full-page ad in Lacrosse magazine, and we had halftime exhibitions at the San Diego Charger games. We told them it was USC against San Diego State, but those were Torrey Pines jerseys and Aztecs were on the field. It was a lot of fun. We had the best home venue in the West. At one point, our record was like 32-4. We hosted the state all-star game, and it was a spectacular venue that we all felt pride in. Of course, now it's just remnants because the facility is now the school's basketball arena. As the only person to have seen each Aztec team in its history, what strikes me as the legacy of the team is the dedication of the players, the camaraderie on the team, and probably most important, the willingness of the players after graduation to give back to the game, not just locally, but across the country. There's no doubt that San Diego State Aztecs, much more than any other college team, have contributed as coaches and referees across the country, and especially in the Southland. When the College League was formed in 1980, an Aztec was the first president. When lacrosse was first initiated in Orange County, in LA, in Ventura County, an Aztec was at the helm. The legacy of Aztec lacrosse is giving back to the game. We have 30 plus years of Russ's camp, and so many former Aztec players served as high school coaches here in San Diego County. Finally, two original Aztecs deserve special mention. When we started youth lacrosse in San Diego, we needed refs. Gary Alabaster said, hey, I'll give it a try. And he became, over the years, one of the best refs on the whole West Coast. He's now the vice president of the National Referee Association. He does the high school championships in Northern California. He does the college championships. He's refereed NCAA Division I games, professional games. Outstanding. And it all started right here in San Diego when we started the Youth Lacrosse League. Second, ask anyone who plays Masters Lacrosse about Cary Mangold, and a smile is sure to come to their face. He played goalie until he retired last year at the age of 68. A proud Vietnam War vet, he had a big hand in fundraising for the Shootout for Soldiers with a national Yahoo Sports article featuring him and his photograph. Last but not least, the glue in this entire program, coach to coach, team to team, has been Craig Miller over the last 15 plus years. His influence on this team has been outstanding, second to none. We have been blessed with many great coaches, from Steve Mann to Pat Lyons to Jeff Hughes, Matt Holman, Charlie Jackson, and now Jesse Foss. Each year I say to myself, this is like the best Aztec lacrosse team I've ever seen. Fellas, we're knocking on the door.
My love hope never to come back.
I see people turn their heads and quickly look away. Like a newborn baby, it just happens every day.
I look inside myself and see my heart is black. I see my red door, I must have it painted black.
Fade away and not have to face the